सिमिलरिटी सिमिलरिटी एंगल एंगल क्राइटेरिया सिमिलरिटी एंगल इंक्लूड एंगल
In two triangles, the corresponding angles are equal. Then their corresponding sides are in the same ratio. Same ratio or proportion. Then, hence the two triangles are similar. And the two triangles are similar. What is the statement of angle criterion of similarity of triangles? In two triangles, the corresponding angles are equal. Angles are equal. In two triangles, the corresponding angles are equal. Their corresponding sides are in same ratio. Corresponding sides are in same ratio or proportion. Hence, the two triangles are similar. We have to prove then the two triangles are similar. Once again, I will explain. In a two triangles, the corresponding angles are equal. Then their corresponding sides are in same ratio or same proportion. Hence the two triangles are similar. First, I will draw the figure. This is named as A, B, C. After I will draw the triangle. Name it as D, E, F. Join P and Q. Okay. This is the given triangle. What is given? In two triangles, the corresponding angles are equal means angle A is must be equal to angle D, angle B is must be equal to angle E, after that angle C is must be equal to angle F. Then their corresponding sides are in same ratio. Corresponding sides are in same ratio. That means AB by DE and also BC by EF and finally AC by DF are same ratio. Hence the two triangles are similar. We have to prove then the two triangles are similar. Now I am going to solution. What is given in this one? What is given? In triangle ABC and the triangle DEF will take in triangle ABC and triangle DEF will take. In triangle ABC and triangle DEF, angle A is must be equal to angle D. DEF, then angle A is must be equal to angle D. After that, angle B is must be equal to angle E. After that, angle C is must be equal to angle F. That I will write angle A equal to angle D. After that, angle B equal to angle E. And angle C equal to angle F. This is the given statement. Okay, what is the proof? Now I am going to RCP required to prove. What we have to prove in this theorem, that is their corresponding sides are in same proportion. That I will write AB by their corresponding side is DE. After I will write BC by EF, BC by EF. After I will write AC by DF, AC by DF. Their corresponding sides are same proportion. This we have required to prove of this theorem. Now I am going to construction. What is their construction? Locate the point. P is 1 point. Q is 1 point. P is located on DE. Q is located on DF. Located the point P and Q. P and Q on DE and P and Q. Locate the point P and Q on DE and locate the point P and Q on the side. On the side DE and DF respectively. So get the point P and Q on the side DE and DP mean DE and DF mean where AB is must be equal to join PQ on this given triangle means where DP is must be equal to AB. After that DQ is must be equal to AC. That I will write. What I have to write in this one means such that AB is must be equal to DP and AC is must be equal to DQ join PQ. PQ అనేది జాయిన్ చేయడం వల్ల AB అనేది DP కి ఈక్వల్ అయ్యింది as well as AC అనేది DQ కి ఈక్వల్ అయ్యింది. Finally now I am going to prove. What is their proof mean? Here first we'll take triangle ABC and triangle DPQ will take in triangle ABC and triangle DPQ. In triangle ABC and triangle DPQ we have. In triangle ABC and triangle DPQ where AB is must be equal to DP. After that, AC is must be equal to DQ. We'll observe. AB is must be equal to DP. After that, AC is must be equal to DQ means P PQ is parallel to EF, then PQ is parallel to EF R. And also, you will observe in this one, AB is must be equal to DB. After that, AC is must be equal to DQ, means here the common angle is A, here the common angle is D, that I will write. Then that implies angle A is must be equal to angle D. Angle A is must be equal to angle D. Now I am going to the next one, that is, as per SAS criterion of similarity of triangles, as per SAS criterion of similarity of triangles, what is given means, triangle ABC, that is triangle ABC is congruent to triangle DPQ. Why? Because of, by SAS means side angle. One angle is must be equal in the triangle ABC and the triangle DPQ, that is angle is equal is A, here equal is D. Here we'll take the two sides, one is AB, another one is AC. After we'll take, this is DP, this is DQ, this is DP, this is DQ. Then by SAS, we'll take two sides and one angle by using, as per SAS criterion of similarity of triangles, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle DF. Triangle ABC is congruent to triangle DEF means, then that we have to written as, both are congruent means their angles are also congruent. That will be written as, angle B is must be equal to angle P. After that, angle C is must be equal to angle Q. Angle C is must be equal to angle Q. Okay, we'll observe. By the problem, what is given? Here we will observe, angle B is equal to angle E is given, angle B is equal to angle E, and here what is given, angle B is equal to angle P is given. Finally, that we have to written as, both LHS values are equal, then both RHS values are also equal. That will be written as, angle E is must be equal to angle P, angle E is must be equal to angle P. After that, I will write the second one, that is, angle C is must be equal to angle F, and here angle C is must be equal to angle Q, then that implies, where both LHS are equal, then both RHS values are also equal. That will be written as, angle F is must be equal to angle Q, angle F is must be equal to angle Q. Here, by using basic proportionality theorem, we'll get, by using basic proportionality theorem, by using BPT, by using BPT we have. We will observe in this triangle, what we have to write in this basic proportionality theorem, where PQ is must be parallel to EF. Why? Because of, angle P is equal to angle E. After that, angle Q is equal to angle F means PQ is parallel to EF. PQ is parallel to EF means, by using the converse of basic proportionality theorem, what we have to write means DP by PE. DP by PE. That must be written as DQ by QF. The reciprocal of given one, that will be written as, what we have to write in this one means, where PE by, here we have to write in this one, reciprocal means PE by DP is must be equal to QF by dq qf by dq. We have to write in this one. What about the value of DE? I will write DE is must be equal to DP plus PE. DP plus PE. So I'm sorry, DP plus PE. What about the value of PE means when PE that I have to written as DE minus DP. After we will take the second one where DF is must be equal to DQ plus QF. Here we have to find the value only QF, where QF that must be take DF minus DQ will take. This is the value of PE. After we'll take this is the value of QF. We have to substitute in this two, where PE that we have to written as DE minus DP by DP is must be equal to QF that we have to written as DF minus DQ by the denominator is DQ. We have to expand in this one that we have to written as DE by DP minus DP by DP is equal to DF by DQ minus DQ by DQ, where DQ, DQ and also DP, DP must be cancelled and remaining is DE by DP that must minus 1 is must be equal to DE by DQ minus 1. Both minus 1 and minus 1 will be cancelled. The reciprocal of given equation that will be written as what we have to write means DP by DE that must be written as DQ by DE. What about the value mean? DF by DE is equal to DQ by, here the value DF, I'm sorry, this is the value DF, this is also DF, so I'm extremely sorry. DP by DE is must be equal to DQ by DF. And also one more thing in this one, where DP is must be equal to AB. DP is must be equal to AB. And also DQ is must be equal to AC. DQ is must be equal to AC. That means what we have to write in this one means, I will write in this side. What we have to write in this one means here DP we have replaced with the AB, that I will write AB by DE. AB by DE is equal to AB by DE is equal to AC by DQ. AB by DE. AB by DE is equal to AC by DF. This is make equation number one. We'll observe AB by DE is must be equal to AC by DF. Again, similarly, we have to take AB by DE is must be take. We will take this one. BC by EF. This is make equation number two. I will write from one and two, what we have to write in this one means AB by DE is equal to BC by EF is equal to, after that, AC by DF. AC by DF. This is the proof of given theorem, required to proof of given theorem. Okay, all corresponding sides are in same ratio means given triangles are similar. That means triangle ABC is similar to triangle DEF. hence proved. And so how to write very neatly, this is most important for public examination. This is the most important theorem. Okay, Nana. Now I am going to next theorem. that is S, 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 right, similarity of triangles, side, 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 similarity of triangles. I will write the statement of side, 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 criterion of similarity. First, I will write their statement. In two triangles, the sides of a one triangle, the sides of a one triangle, proportional to the corresponding sides of other triangle, then their corresponding angles are equal. Corresponding angles are equal. And hence, the two triangles are similar. Observe in this one. In two triangles, the sides of a one triangle is proportional to the corresponding sides of other triangle that I will take. This is the given triangle. Name it as A, B, C. After, we will take the another triangle, name it as D, E, F. I will join P and Q. What is given statement? If two triangles are take the sides of one triangle proportional to the corresponding sides of other triangle, that means AB that I have to take DE, and also BC that I have to take EF, again AC that I have to take EF, then the corresponding angles are equal. We have to prove angle A is equal to angle D, angle B is equal to angle E, after that angle C is equal to angle F, and the two triangles are similar. We have to prove in this one. First, what is given? Now I am going to solution. In triangle ABC and triangle DEF, their corresponding sides are proportional, that I will take AB by DE. After we'll take BC by F. After we'll take AC by DF. AC by DF is less than 1. This is the given one. What we have to prove? There are RCB required to prove. What we have to prove in this one means, then their corresponding angles are equal. Then their equal means angle A is equal to angle D. After that, angle B is equal to angle A. After that, angle C is equal to angle F. We have to prove in this one. Angle A equal to angle D. Angle B equal to angle E. Angle C is equal to angle F. Okay, what is their construction? Locate P and Q on the sides of one is DE and DF respectively such that locate P and Q on the sides DE and DF means where AB is must be equal to DP. AB is must be equal to DP and AC is must be equal to DQ. AC is must be equal to DQ. Join. Eppudu equal avutayante PQ ni join chesinappudu maatrame equal avutayi. Okay, now I am going to prove. What is the proof of given theorem? First, I will take in triangle ABC and triangle DF. First, I will take in triangle ABC and the triangle DEF. Will take what I have to write in this one. Their corresponding sides are equal. That means AB by DE that must be equal to AC by DF. I will write that one. AB by DE is must be equal to AC by DF. We know AB is must be equal to DP. AB is must be equal to DP. After that, AC is must be equal to DQ. I will write that two. AC is must be equal to DQ. We have to substitute in this two. I will write in this one where AB we have to substitute with DP. That means DP by DE is equal to, where AC is must be equal to DQ. DQ by DF. We will observe in this figure where DP by DE is equal to DQ by DF, where the common angle is D. You'll observe in this one, where DP by DE is must be equal to DQ by DF. DQ by DF. That means, where here the common angle that will take D, that we have to written as DP by DE is equal to DQ by DF. Then PQ is parallel to EF, that I will write, where PQ is parallel to EF. What is the reason means we will observe in this one, where the common angle is DD, here also common angle is DD. That means here the numerator PQ is must be parallel of EF. What the concept to use means by converse of basic proportionality theorem. By converse of basic proportionality theorem, PQ is must be parallel to EF. I will write what is the parallel in this given one. There, PQ is parallel to EF. Where PQ is parallel to EF. Where PQ is parallel to EF means angle P is must be equal to angle G. After that, angle Q is must be equal to angle F. I will write that too. PQ is parallel to EF means angle P is must be equal to angle E, and angle Q is must be equal to angle F. Okay. By previous theorem, what is the previous theorem? By angle criterion of similarity of triangles. Okay, here angle P is must be equal to angle E. After that, angle Q is must be equal to angle F by the problem. Okay, what I have to write in this one means DP by DE. That means DP by DE. After I will write DQ by DF. DQ by DF is must be equal to, what is their parallel line? Here PQ is parallel to EF. That I will write PQ by EF. Here I have to write in this one PQ by EF. But when the line PQ is must be equal to BC, that I will write PQ is must be equal to BC. What I have to write in this one means DP by DE is must be equal to DQ by DF must be equal to PQ by EF when it is equal to. What about the value of PQ here? PQ I have to replace with BC by EF. We will observe in these two sides of given triangle will take. That means PQ by EF is equal to BC by EF means triangle ABC is congruent to triangle DPQ. That is, I will write in this one, PQ by EF is must be equal to BC by EF mean, where PQ, here the common angle is will take D, after BC here common angle will take A, both will be congruent. That I will write triangle ABC is congruent to triangle DPQ. Triangle ABC is congruent to triangle DPQ means where angle A is must be equal to angle D. Angle A is must be equal to angle D. After that, angle B is equal to angle P. Angle B is equal to angle P. Already we know angle P is equal to angle E. Angle P is equal to angle E. Angle P is equal to angle E. We'll observe in this one. Angle B is equal to angle P and angle P is equal to angle E. What I have to write in this one means, that is, angle B is equal to angle P and angle P is equal to angle E means, finally, angle B is must be equal to angle E. And one more thing in this one, angle C is must be equal to angle Q. That I will write. Here also, angle C is must be equal to angle Q. By the problem, angle Q is must be equal to angle F. That I will write. Angle Q is must be equal to angle F. That is, angle C is equal to angle Q and angle Q is equal to angle F. Then that implies angle C is equal to angle F. That is, so what is the equal in this angle? That is, angle A is equal to angle D. After that, angle B is equal to angle E. After that, angle C is equal to angle F. Once again, we will observe in this one. Angle A is must be equal to angle D. After that, angle B is must be equal to angle E. One more is, angle C is must be equal to angle F. I will write that one. Angle A is equal to angle D. Angle A is equal to angle D, comma. Angle B is equal to angle E and angle C is equal to angle F. This is the proof of given theorem. angle A is must be equal to angle D, angle B is equal to angle A, angle C is equal to angle F means triangle ABC is similar to triangle DEF. Triangle DEF and true. Hence the proof. This is the proof of given theorem. This is most important. How to write very neatly in your notebook. Okay, one more theorem there. I will explain in next class. Once again, I will explain this theorem. This is most important. What is given in this one? I'll observe. Yes, yes, yes. Criterion of similarity of triangles. Criterion of similarity of triangles. What is given in this statement? If two triangles, the side of a one triangle, the side of a one triangle proportional to the corresponding sides of other triangle. If AB is proportional to DE, then their corresponding angles are equal. Okay, అవి జన ప్రపోర్షనల్ గా ఉంటే దాని యొక్క యాంగిల్స్ ఈక్వల్ అవుతాయి అంటున్నాడు. యాంగిల్ ఏ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు యాంగిల్ డి, యాంగిల్ బి ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు యాంగిల్ ఈ, యాంగిల్ సి ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు యాంగిల్ ఎఫ్. ఓకే, దిస్ ఈస్ గివెన్. వాట్ ఈస్ గివెన్? ఇన్ ట్రయాంగిల్ ఏబిసి అండ్ ట్రయాంగిల్ డిఈఎఫ్ దేర్ కరస్పాండింగ్ సైడ్స్ ఆర్ ఈక్వల్ మీన్స్ ఏబి బై డిఈ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు బిసి బై ఎఫ్ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు ఏసి బై డిఎఫ్ is less than 1, where it is a scale factor. What do I have to prove? Angle A is equal to angle D, angle B is equal to angle E, angle C is equal to angle F. Look at construction. Look at P and Q on the sides of DE and DF respectively. Then AB is must be equal to DEP. After that, AC is equal to DQ. Join PQ. In triangle ABC and the triangle DEF, we get what we have to write in this one means AB by DE is equal to AC by DF, where here given AB that must be equal to DP, after that AC that must be equal to DQ. We have to substitute in this one. That must be written as DP by DE is equal to DQ by DF. Here the common angle is D, that is PQ is parallel to EF. By the converse of basic proportionality theorem, after PQ is parallel to EF means angle P is equal to angle EF, angle Q is equal to angle F, that I will write. Again, by using angle criterion of similarity of triangles, we will write DP by DE is must be written as GQ by DF is equal to, where the parallel lines PQ by EF, where in this given two triangles PQ is must be equal to BC, that I have to substitute PQ with BC. Here PQ by BC is equal to, PQ by EF is equal to BC by EF means both triangles are congruent. Both triangles are congruent means angle A is must be equal to angle D, angle B is equal to angle P, angle P is equal to angle G. Finally, that's why I have written as angle B is equal to angle E. After that, angle C is equal to angle Q, angle Q is equal to angle F. Finally, angle C is equal to angle F. That I will write this one. Finally, triangle A, B, C is congruent to triangle D, E, F. These two theorems, one more theorem there. These three theorems are most important. Repeat kala nerchukondi neat ga. Pranath, see you next class.